Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guests have been together for 11 years and got married as a couple of years ago. And when they were faced with some issues in their relationship, they sought help on the new own reality show, Love Goals. Let's take a look.
They have to understand that that's our home and it's not a hangout for the guys.
I went to elementary school, middle school, high school, college, and played NFL with the same people from the hood.
Theresa don't really understand when you're the one that made it out of the hood, you have to bring your homies with you. So I can't turn my back on my boys. She just don't understand.
Former NFL wide receiver and rapper Dwayne and his beautiful wife, Theresa.
Thank you for having us. Thank you.
Yes, we're happy to have you down to the circle to talk about your relationships.
Now, I got a question about the relationship.
You do?
Talk to me.
Yeah, now you would, you've been together for 11 years, but you just recently got married. How long you been married? 2 years.
2 years.
What took you so long?
I had to wait till I retire because it was so much.
Don't do that.
This is from the,
don't get
this
me
from
started
the soil
this table
now. If you want to, that's why a lot of relationships don't last when guys are professional athletes, because they flying over here, hooking up with this person, Instagram out, follow me, tap them. You know what I'm saying?
As a woman, I needed to be patient too, because you don't want your husband in a strip club every day. Ooh. It came with that lifestyle of him being in a strip club, and I'm like, I'm not about to marry you and have to be coming to the strip club yanking you out. So
right.
He got it out of his system, and he became a whole different guy after the league.
How did you meet? Did you just?
My first year, as soon as I touched down in Kansas City after I got drafted in 2007, mm-hmm. she was the first lady who they brought me to sell me a house. And I was looking like, she looked just like this, and I was like, this might be a setup. We just had a meeting, and they said, watch out for the woman that look the prettiest, or they gonna try to take your money.
That's what they tell you?
That's what they tell us, young black man, soon we get a lot of money, watch out for this type.
But this was business, so he gave the business to someone else.
After
I showed him 25 houses, he went and bought it from not a black woman, he went to this older white lady, which I feel like is stereotypical in the real estate community.
He didn't buy the house from you?
No.
But I bought
and
my
that's
last
your husband?
I bought my last five from her, though.
Yeah.
You better clean that up. Mm-hmm. You know what we're doing
now.
Not
only that, she's sitting over there with a ring on her finger.
She
sure is.
Showed up, came out on top.
Okay.
Dwayne, you were in the NFL for 10 years.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Before you retired from the Kansas City Chiefs.
Yes.
The question I have for both of you, which quite kind of came out the gate to kind of kick it off.
Mm-hmm.
No. It wasn't the same question. It wasn't the same question. But you gave the energy for this question.
Yes.
Okay. I'm married to an athlete as well, ex-athlete, mm-hmm. retired basketball player.
Okay.
Talk to us about the difficulties, and maybe, both of you can answer this question from both points, both perspectives. What are the difficulties when being in a marriage with a professional athlete? We heard a little bit of it, but what are some of the other things that can really damage your marriage?
I would say time is, when you a professional athlete, to perfect your craft, you gotta be pulled in so many different areas to become this awesome professional athlete.
Yes.
And if you're married and you got kids, that means you're taking time away from her, you're taking time away from the kids, and you can kind of get lost in the sauce. But if that's your best friend and you know that's the goal, mm-hmm. and y'all a team, and we're a team, it's my best friend. So when we came together, we was like, I'm gonna do this, you do this, and we're gonna meet in the middle. And that's what she did. She stayed busy, she had her own, and that's how it worked out.
And I think for me, he became popular overnight, and with that comes new friends, mm-hmm. people knocking down the door that we didn't know. Mm-hmm. So my problem came from who are these people? And it was mm-hmm. almost I had to step back and realize he had been afforded an amazing life. I have to be patient. I don't I love Beyonce. So Beyonce was knocking down my door come hang with me. I wouldn't want him to say, girl, stay in the house.
Right.
So I let him, I let him be him, and that was the basis of our relationship.
But could you be you?
Yes.
Okay.
So that's the whole thing. It's I had to let him live and I had to continue to live.
Okay.
Some women get so engulfed in their man and they mm-hmm. want to do everything with their man that they get lost.
Mm-hmm.
So I continue to thrive in my own career, and that's why I continue to be successful.
Yeah, mm-hmm. that's good stuff.
And that was attractive to you, wasn't it, Dwayne?
It was.
I want the men to want the women who
you
got it going
she
on. Stop
the
messing
table.
With the video vixens
the
and the
table.
Instagram
just,
models that just all they're doing is the back shots. Go with the women who
got
it going on.
Who got it. Yeah, I was a gold digger. I went for the one who had it. I was a gold digger. So this is the opposite. You know what I'm saying? Grandma told me to make sure you find somebody like me that can take care of you, and I found one. And
it's smart. It's smart that he did look for a woman that, you know, can hold him down as well. It's not financially. It's just somebody that's smart, because a lot of athletes, they're, you know, they're just all over the place. They don't handle a lot of their own business. But if you have a businesswoman, it's like they can help you and make sure you see things that you're not looking for.
Oh my God! I'm in love with them.
So leave him alone.
I'm not leaving him alone.
You're trying to take him out here.
You don't feel like I'm trying to take you out. But you know what he coming to when he come to the circle? You know I'm here.
But this is good. This is good because I'm always around guys. So girls, help me. Give me some girl power. It's always the boys.
Let's talk a little bit about Love Goals. What made you guys do it? What was the experience like? What's going to be the takeaway for people who are watching, like myself?
Good stuff.
I was at my breaking point. When he retired, I thought it was going to be family, and he embarked upon his first love, which was music. So with that came even more. And I was like, what is happening? So I would wake up and go to sleep almost by myself. Started feeling lonely, and I'm like, okay, let me reach out and try to get counseling. And then we got the phone call. And it was the OWN network, and it was, I just knew where Oprah came the best. So, you know, I encouraged him. I'm like, please, let's just try it. And he was first like,
I was so against it. You know, us being they never tell us we need to, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, I don't need it. But then she kept crying out for the attention. I was like, okay, let me just pray, ask God to show me.
This woman fine is all out.
That's what I'm saying, but you can't see it.
She should have been crying for nothing.
Well, look here, what kind of love goals did you all find doing this show?
Especially with spirit.
Spirit is amazing.
Spirit is beyond amazing.
She is the bomb.
When I tell you, like, that woman, the way she walks in the room and demands respect. She controlled five couples, and we had Benzino on the show, and he was like a ticking time bomb. And for me to see her be able to control him and like tame him, it was amazing. But she is super smart.
And she keeps it 100, too.
My husband like took her direction. And you know, for somebody like him to do that, I was like, kudos to Spirit. She's amazing.
Well, Spirit's gonna be on our show next week. She's a friend to the show. And we're glad that you all came down and you know, be able to get a front seat to what couples like you have endured over time. So continued success. I wish you nothing but the greatest. And black love is beautiful. Make sure you follow Dwayne on Instagram at _MoneyBowe and Theresa at Mrs82. And be sure to watch them on Love Goals on OWN this Saturday. Let's give it up for the Bowe.